Dear students, very good morning. Now today I'm going to take chapter 3, theories of employment and income. See, last time I used to write on the board. Now what I planned is I will put all the lessons in PowerPoint, and if you want you can take the notes also. Okay students, so the chapter 3 is theories of employment and income. Now we'll see what exactly is introduction. Actually, they say that the economic history has shown many countries facing economic problems. The main problem is unemployment. Out of these problems, unemployment is the most vexing. Both classical and Keynes have explained the relationship between employment and income. We'll see, this is just an introduction part. I will just move on to the next slide and we'll see what exactly is employment. Meaning of full employment. Any person able to one who is willing to work is called as employment. So here he says, able-bodied person who is willing to work at the prevailing wage, is employed. Second point is, full employment means that person who are willing to work and able to work must have employment or a job. Next, Keynes defines full employment as the absence of involuntary unemployment. Okay, so this is just an introduction part. You can write any one of the definitions in this particular employment. Any one thing. You can write the first one. Able-bodied person who is willing to work at the prevailing wage rate is employed. So you might get this for 2 marks or 1 mark. Next, what is unemployment? Unemployment is problem faced when there are people who are willing to work and able to work but cannot find suitable jobs. This is a very important point. Cannot find suitable jobs. Okay. Now the following are the types of unemployment: cyclical, seasonal, frictional, educated, technical, structural, and disguised unemployment. Now we'll see all this employment one by one. First one, what is cyclical unemployment? As I've told you in the first chapter about the trade cycle. So here it says this unemployment exists during the turnover trade cycle in the economy, that is recession and depression. In a business cycle, during a period of recession and depression, income and output fall, leading to widespread unemployment. It is caused by deficiency of effective demand. That means to say that there is no demand in the market, so we get this cyclical unemployment. Cyclical unemployment can be cured by public investment or expansion monetary policy. Again, I come back to cyclical employment. I told you about the different trade phases: boom, recession, depression, recovery. Please understand the 4 concepts: boom, recession, depression, and recovery. Next, we go to the next slide, that is seasonal unemployment. What is seasonal employment is, during a particular period of the month during the year, there would not be any employment. So this type of unemployment is during certain seasons of the year. Now let's give an example. During January, what do we do? We do harvesting. And in February, March, there would not be sown, we don't grow any crops at all. So that particular time is called as seasonal unemployment. Now in agricultural agro-based industries like sugar production activities are carried out only in some seasons. So that means only during the sugarcane production activities you will have the employment. Apart from that, you will not have any employment. Now these industries offer employment only during a season in that particular year. Therefore, people will remain unemployed during the off-season. So off-season is nothing but after the harvesting of any sugarcane crops, people will not have any job. Now seasonal unemployment happens from demand side also. For example, ice cream industry. So this particular ice cream industry will work only during the summer time, because during the winter time people would avoid eating ice cream. Holiday resorts, again one more a very good example of seasonal unemployment. Next, frictional unemployment or temporary unemployment. This arises due to imbalance between supply of labor and demand of labor. That means this is because of immobility of labor, lack of necessary skills, breakdown of machinery, shortage of raw materials. So this particular frictional employment occurs, this three stages of these points: lack of necessary skills, breakdown of machineries or parts, or if you do not get raw materials for the production, then frictional unemployment is one. The persons who lose jobs and in search of jobs are also included under frictional unemployment. Right, so in this you can take only these two points: necessary skills, breakdown of machinery, and shortage of raw materials. Next, educated unemployment. That means a person who is educated will not get suitable jobs. So here we say sometimes educated people are unemployed or when qualification does not match the job. This is a very important point. Qualification does not match the job. Then faulty education system, very good. Lack of employable skills. Mass student turnout, because I can give a very good example. In India, we got a lot of engineering students working under different areas. So every year about 10 to 15 lakh engineers come outside every year. Okay, so because of that also, and moreover, preference for white collar jobs. So a person who has completed engineering, BSc, they would not prefer doing any hardcore jobs. So they would always expect white collar jobs. Okay, that is one more thing. Next is technical unemployment. Modern technology being capital intensive requires less labor. So that means to say, I'll give a very good example about technical unemployment. You would have seen manufacturing of cars. So we will never find any employees out there. Everything is being done by robots. So that is one more thing. So less manpower, more machinery, more technology. Nowadays, invention and innovations lead to the adoption of new techniques, thereby existing workers are entrenched. So what is happening out is this, due to more technology and science, what is happening is that less manpower and more machineries. I can give a very good example about CNC, computerized numerical machines. So the manufacturing of cars has been done by CNC machines. So labor saving devices are also responsible. So what the company thinks is that if a machine can work, then I do not need any to pay the labors. That is one more very important point. Structural unemployment is due to drastic change in the structure of the society. Lack of demand for the product or shifting demand. Now let's take an example. Nowadays we people do not buy any cameras. So that camera has been replaced by what? Mobile phones. So people do not buy cameras. CD players, DVD players. Now CD and DVD players are being replaced by what? Pen drives. So this kind of unemployment results from massive and deep-rooted changes in economic structure. Next, disguised unemployment occurs when more people are there than what is actually required. Okay, so that means what? More labors, less work. So even if some workers are withdrawn, production does not suffer. Yes, it's something like this. If 10 people are doing a job, 5 people can do it. So remaining 5 are, even if they are not there, but still the production will carry on. A person is said to be disguised by unemployed if his contribution to output is less. Very important point. Contribution to output is less. Then what you can produce by working for normal hours per day. In this situation, marginal productivity of labor is zero or negative. So that means to say that his production is either zero or negative.